Oh, I wish I was in a land of cotton. Old time there are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland.
Oh, I wish I was in Dixie, away, away. In Dixieland I'll take my stand, to live and die in Dixie.
In Dixieland, where I was born, early Lord, one frosty morn, look away, look away, look away, Dixieland.
Lord, this world below.
this hand still leads me as I go. I'm trusting to the unseen hand that this old weary land, and some sweet day I'll reach as and still guided by. Just remember in his word how he feeds the little birds. Take your burdens to the Lord and leave them there. Leave them there.
Leave them there.
Leave them there.
Leave them there.
Take your burdens to the Lord and leave them there. When your youthful days are gone and old age is creeping on, and your body's bent beneath a load of care,
the Lord of care,
he will never leave you then. He'll go with you to the end. Take your burden to the Lord and leave them there. Leave them there. Trust and never doubt, he will shoot. he must know something, but don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling, he keeps on rolling along. And him that plants 'em am soon forgotten. But old man River, he just keeps rolling along. We sweat and strain, body all aching and racked with pain. Tote that bar, lift that bale, get a little sick, and you land in jail. I'm tired of living and feared of dying. But old man River, he just keeps rolling
to say.
joy is waiting for me when I hear Jesus say, come home,
my child, come home.
One Sunday morning I was in Springfield, Missouri, and traveling on the road and singing like a gospel quartet does, we have very little time to attend a church or attend one regularly. So on Sunday morning, I usually spend my time listening to ministers on television. This one Sunday morning, I cut on the TV after coming in, after riding all night and getting ready to go to bed and take a nap. I cut on the television and heard Rex Humbard preach a sermon. After hearing him preach this sermon, I wrote this narration. The title of it is Just Thinking Out Loud. You hear people talk about doing their thing. To some it's dope, or anything for a fling. To a lot of folks, it's glutton, or maybe even pride. Some run down a friend until his influence has died. To others, it's position, or what my daddy has been. And to some, it's their money to spend with no end. To some it's their car or home they possess. Or maybe it's diamonds or how well one can dress. All of this in the Bible, we're told, will only bring vanity and cost us our soul. None of these things represents God's love. None will enhance the things up above. Do unto others as you would have them do. These kind of folks today are very few. If you see your brother failing, don't look at him in doubt. Just tell it to the Lord and let him work it out. If you see a friend or a neighbor that's in need, go to his rescue. This is called a good deed. If you see a man who is drunken with wine, it's easy to say that he's lower than swine. Don't curse a man until you've stood in his shoes. Think of his soul. That's what he can lose. Why not stop and give him a hand? Take just a moment and tell him God's plan. The love of God is shown only one way. That's by you, my friend. What have you done today? Do you know a widow who's got children to feed? Did you call today to see what they need? Or were you afraid it might cost you a dime, or maybe keep you from being on time? Do you know a neighbor that's sick and in bed? Did you go by and pray? Well, they could even be dead. There's an old proverb, if we ever succeed, It'll be by helping our brother, our friend, who's in need. Hope you don't think I'm pointing a finger at you. I'm just merely thinking out loud to see what I can do.
Broken heart. Then you spread your wings
Little baby.